Heat waves are off the charts. In today's video, I'll walk you through what's going on, why it's so hot, and most importantly, what a new field of science can tell us about if we're to blame. If you like this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. So let's get started with the steamy summer of 2023. 114 degrees Fahrenheit in Spain, 115 in Texas in June, breaking records for the day and the month. And in Phoenix, Arizona, 31 consecutive days above 110, obliterating the record. And for over 2 weeks at night, it didn't fall below 90. But we're not just seeing heat waves and records shattered. Heat waves are getting weird.
So in recent days, we've seen some near record high temperatures, but increasingly what's becoming maybe not normal is just how persistent these heat waves are. For it to be 110 in Las Vegas is normal. For it to be 110 very frequently throughout the summer, or for many, many days in a row, is less normal.
And in cold northern places like New England, the strangest weather is happening in the winter.
We've seen warming throughout the year, but the most pronounced warming has happened during the winter season. Our winter seasons are actually warming at a rate about three times that of the summer warm season. And that has resulted in an overall shorter cold season and a less extreme cold season, so a milder cold season.
Heat waves are the deadliest weather-related disaster in the U.S. Extreme temperatures cause heat exhaustion and severe dehydration, and they raise the risk of having a heart attack or stroke.
The impact that we're having in Phoenix and all of our cities and towns in Arizona is the urban heat island. Phoenix is a very large metropolitan area. And when you're looking at the cement sidewalks and the parking lots and the buildings, those hold on to the sunlight. They hold on to the heat and cool off very slowly at night. And so that causes our nighttime temperatures to increase. So those minimum temperatures are really that dangerous threshold. If people can't cool off at night, then they're at risk from heat-related illnesses.
So what's going on? Air temperatures on Earth have been rising since the Industrial Revolution. According to NOAA, the world has warmed 1.9 degrees Fahrenheit since 1880. Most climate records using thermometers date back to the 1850s, but scientists can use other data to look even further back into the past.
Pollen data can tell you what type of vegetation was in place. And we know the temperature zones at which certain species of plants as well as animals can exist. And so if you find records of those animals either through proxies or fossils, we can assume that that temperature range was at that place when that deposit was made. Also have ocean cores. You can take gas samples from the little bubbles in glaciers. Also tree rings. Trees grow faster when it's warmer and wetter than when it's colder and drier. And so you can also get estimates of climate variables like temperature and precipitation from those sources that date back before our instrumentation record.
The data tells us that our temperatures are warmer than they've been since the dawn of agriculture.
This year is probably the warmest we've had since the last glacial period, which takes us back about 10,000 years. The last interglacial before that was about 120,000, 125,000 years ago. And that was warmer than this one had been. On the other hand, the carbon dioxide concentrations in the atmosphere are definitely higher than they were then. So if they stay high, we will bust through the temperatures from 120,000 years ago pretty easily.
But why is it so hot? There are a few reasons. First, there's the return in 2023 of El Niño, the periodic warming of the eastern Pacific Ocean waters. It's associated with record warmth and extreme heat. Our buildings and roads absorb heat, making cities hotter than surrounding areas. And finally, fossil fuels. Burning coal, oil, and gas release heat-trapping pollution into the atmosphere. Similar to a blanket, this traps in heat and is pushing us into a hotter future.
When the average temperature of the Earth goes up, the extreme heat goes up even more. So we are seeing more extreme heat, more very extreme heat. You know, we're used to breaking records by a tenth of a degree, maybe a quarter of a degree, very rarely by a whole degree. We're now breaking temperature records in some of these heat waves by as much as 10 degrees Fahrenheit.
A relatively new branch of climate science sheds more light on our role. Just like researchers compare data from smokers and non-smokers to show the link to lung cancer, climate scientists are now comparing data from planet Earth to a sophisticated computer model of an Earth with no climate change.
We used to say, well, you can't blame any one event on climate change. Well, we now actually can, because there are some events that would not have happened if not for climate change. So in that sense, it did cause that event. In most cases, it's making them worse. It's not causing the heat wave, but it's exacerbating it. It's making it hotter, it's making it longer lasting, it's making it cover a wider area. And that's true of many of these extreme weather changes that we're seeing.
At the World Weather Attribution Initiative, researchers calculated how much climate change contributed to the 2023 heat waves in Texas, Arizona, and in Southern Europe. Their findings: without human-caused climate change, the heat waves would have been virtually impossible.
What we're seeing now is human-caused climate change, climate disruption. That's the way most people are experiencing climate change, is through these extreme events, the exacerbation of heat waves.
It's a problem, not just for polar bears or future generations, but for us today.
We are already seeing these effects now. This is not a future problem to deal with. This is a now problem. These extremes, particularly the extreme heat, the impact on our winter, and extreme precipitation, are only going to get worse with time.
So as our world continues to warm, temperature records look set to keep on breaking. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel. And for more climate change coverage, visit our website at climateconnections.org.